Good morning, children. Today we are going to know something about post office. Post office is a central government postal departmental system where you can buy stamps, post letters, postcards, inland letters, and send parcels, money order, and etc. It provides mail services such as accepting letters and parcels. The primary function of post office is collection, processing, transmission, and delivery of mail. Children, did you send letters to your relatives? No, because you have mobile phones. If you want to talk or send messages, chat with them through the mobile phones, isn't it? But on those days, that is 25 or 30 years back, there was no such facilities. People send messages and parcels to their relatives or friends only through letters or postcards. It's very glad experience out among us when through post office we send letter. It takes 2 or 3 days to reach according to the distance. So post office carry our messages to our relatives to they are in distant places. So it is very useful department for the public. People post letters in post boxes which are kept at convenient locations in the cities. The letters are collected and reached the post office by a postman after they are sorted on the basis of their locations. Then they are sent to the post offices in the destination locations. Finally, the letters are reached to their actual destination by the postmaster. Then the letters are delivered by the postman in the homes of the addresses or at business places. Usually, the post service will take about 3 to 4 days to reach the receiver. If there is any emergency to send the letter, there is a facility called speed post. With this, you can receive the letter by the next day itself. Also, we can buy postcards, inland letters, stamps in the post office. Now let's see the stamps, postcard, and letters. First one, stamps. Stamps are on two types. They are revenue stamp and postage stamp. Revenue stamp is cost at 1 rupee. Postage stamp is various costs. These stamps are in the great persons of our India, and their photos are placed in the stamps. Our government release stamps to honor the great persons and with their names. So these postage stamps, currently available postage stamps are Subhash Chandra Bose, Mrs. Subbulakshmi, Srinivasa Ramanujam. These few stamps are here available. And you know that stamp collection is a good hobby, isn't it? So students collect old and new stamps and make an album. Okay. Next, we'll see the postcards and its types. Postcard is an open communication on a card of prescribed size. This is open communication. postcards are used for transmission within India only. And also we can use these postcards for writing the answers of puzzles given in magazines and newspaper for getting prizes. Now these postcards are available in two varieties, single and reply postcard. Its dimensions is 14 centimeter by 9 centimeter. Next one, printed postcard. Postcards containing communication recorded by printing, cyclostyling or any other mechanical process are classified as printed postcards. Printed matter includes printed pictures also. Next one, Meghdoot postcard. The portion next to the address is available for advertisement in four colors. So in these postcards, we write the messages in one side and the other side write the address in the right corner, right side, right of the right portion. The left portion we can use for advertisement in colors. Inland letter. Communication is contained on a sheet of paper with prescribed size and folding. Inland letter code is used for transmission within India only. So in this we write the communication, the messages, matter in one side of the paper, the back side of the paper, and here this one fourth of the paper is the empty space. We write the messages and then fold it and paste and then write on the envelope address. We write the address on the envelope and post it. Acknowledgement card. When we send application to a company or an exam, we attach this acknowledgement card with the application filled with self address. The application reached to the company or exam center, they take the application and return the acknowledgement card to us. This shows that the application reached the place correctly and in time. But nowadays we send through email and within a second. Domestic mail products. That means we send the postman supply the letters and mail things to the home, to the doorsteps. They are called domestic mail products. They are letters, book packet, parcel, registered newspaper, inland letter, postcard and blind literature packets. Types of posts. Registered post, speed post. So first we'll see registered post. The post should be delivered to the registered particular person only. That means if we send a letter through the registered post or send money order, obviously we have to use this registered post for money order or parcels to a particular person. So for that we better use registered post. So if you send this through send the letter through this, the post should be delivered to the registered particular person. If I post a letter to you, to your name, the postman deliver the letter to you only, not to your relatives. They inform to your relative or neighbor and send back the letter to the post office. Then we are going go to post office and get back the letter or money order or person. Okay, so for that purpose you are using the registered post. The next one is speed post. It is known as, from the name itself, speed, for sending the letter very quick, urgent. The letter is very urgent, the message is very urgent to know the person, so we choose the speed post. The post can be delivered to the same persons or their relatives. If the letter reach earlier fast, you use speed post. The speed post and parcels can be booked in post office by measuring the weight in weighing machine, and the amount is charged according to their weight. Apart from this, the post office is very helpful for middle class people. How? By saving schemes. Let's see the schemes. Yes, savings is very important in everyone's life. We should save a little amount of our earnings every month. It's very helpful to our future. Post office encourages the children to have the habit of savings. Yes, because of the minimum amount of savings account is rupees 20. So, children also can join savings account in post office. There are many saving schemes which help the people from low level to high level. So when you save money, if it is even 1 rupee or 10 rupees, whatever you have, you put in a piggy bank. If you can, it is better to create an account in a post office, because it has very lowest amount, is starting from the lowest amount an account. If not, you can, at least you can save money at home by using a piggy bank. If you save this much, like 1 rupee or 50 rupees or 10 rupees, whatever you have in your hand, the children, for you, they give, your parents give money to you, you save like this, after the year, you have a handful of money. You can use this money to buy any one of your use. Okay, so it's very exciting moment of using our money, isn't it? So today onwards, you start to save. Now let's see the schemes in a saving schemes in the post office. The first one of the savings scheme is post office savings account, that is SB. This is individual and joint account. It gives the rate of interest 4% per annum. And the minimum amount of starting an account is rupees 500. Next one is post office time deposit account, that is called TD. This is also individual and joint account. It gives some plenty of rate of interest per annum. This starting amount, that is minimum amount to start a account, is rupees 1000. Next one is monthly income scheme account. It is called as MIS. M for monthly, I for income, S for scheme. Monthly income scheme account. This is also joint and individual account. It gives the rate of interest 6.6% per annum. It's long-term account. This minimum amount of starting an account is rupees 20. So if we select a long term, it's very benefit. So this is the minimum amount is 20. So even as children also can create an account. Next one, senior citizen savings scheme account. That is senior citizen savings scheme. Yes, C, yes, yes. In this name itself, we know that senior citizen. Who are they? The old person. That means they got a retirement. They get a PF amount and so for these amounts they can save in a post office. So for this they have a lump of amount so that they can start multiples of 1000. The minimum amount of account is 1000 and multiples of 1000. The rate of interest is 7.4% per annum. So highest percentage is given for the senior citizen. Okay, so it is very safe and riskless of these schemes because it is central government schemes. Next one, public provident fund. This scheme gives a rate of interest 7.1% per annum. Yes, this BPF, that is public provident fund, gives 7.1% per annum. This is also long-term investment saving scheme. The minimum amount to start an account is rupees 100. Okay, it's very useful, no? So for rural people also can use these schemes. And next one, national savings certificate. This is also, it's a certificate scheme, savings. And one more thing is recurring deposit account, RD, recurring deposit. That is RD. We usually know that most of the people are starting this recurring deposit account. Other than the remaining, this is very popular among the people. So this minimum amount is starting an account is rupees 100. It gives 5.8% of interest per annum. And also for all the schemes, the post office gives the compound interest. You know that for simple interest and compound interest, simple interest is smaller than the compound interest. This interest is added to the principal, and together they calculate the interest for the upcoming years. And also this compound interest is calculated in some schemes in quarterly. That means 4 months once. They give the interest on per year only, but they calculated 4 months once. That means it's a quarterly, it gives quarterly, half yearly, it gives a more interest. It is benefit for you so that you can join these schemes in post office. Next one, the last, Sukanya Samriddhi account. That means the Prime Minister giving the girl child scheme, Ponmahal Thittam. So this is Sukanya Samriddhi account gives 7.6% of interest per annum. This is long term scheme. The minimum amount of starting an account is ₹250. This is usually we are known about this Sukanya Samriddhi account is Ponmahal Thittam. For a girl child, they after 10 years, the girl child gets 10 years old, we can start this account. We pay minimum amount ₹250 and more than what you like. And likewise, the Ponmahan Thittam, like girl child, they given a boy child also. If you have boy child, you also can start a scheme, you can join a scheme in this scheme. The same benefits you will get. So after 10 years, you can pay. This is long-term savings scheme. This 21 years. You have to pay 21 years. You can withdraw the amount after 21 years, or the child gets 21 years for the girl child's marriage or the education of the child. It is very, very useful to save the children. And life insurance scheme also available in the post office. So these all schemes are very useful and safe, very safe. This is government department, so your amount is very safe. So start any one of the account and utilize your future. Now, how to open a post office savings account? Yes, that is, post office savings account can be opened by adults or on behalf of minor, that is below 10 years and 10 years above. For that, you need to get a form from the nearest post office or online and submit the duly filled and signed form along with other requisite documents. Pay the minimum amount as per chosen scheme. After the KYC, that means Know Your Customer form, is over, then your deposit account will be opened for you. So post office schemes provide risk-free on the investments as they are backed by the government. So no worry about of your money, it's safe. So you have to, everyone should open any one of the postal scheme and start saving now. Thus, the post office is wonderful establishment for all people. Save money, stay safe, stay home. Thank you.